Good morning students, once again I welcome you all to my video. This is the video of class 9 subject biology. So as we were continuing with our second chapter, that is the tissue. So as in the flow chart, or in the we can say the that means in the distribution, we had seen that animal tissue is categorized into four type: epithelial, connective, muscular and nervous. So up to the previous video we had completed our epithelial tissue. So here we start with our new topic, that is the connective tissue. So connective tissue is little bit lengthier. So just I will complete this topic into two or three videos. So let's start with the connective tissue. So if I talk about the name, that is the connective tissue. Now what does the mean? The name is here, it is telling the connective means it is connecting two things. So this means connective means to connect one to the other thing. So here that means the function, if I talk about the function of the connective tissue, so connective tissue has a main building, supporting and packaging function. That means they will just hold everything connected, just like if these two things are over here. If these two things are over here, so they will hold this one also, they will hold this one also. So this is the function of the connective tissue, and this is the tissue that is that means mostly spreaded in the whole body, and they are also that means the cells over there, they are also living cells. So let's discuss the connective tissue in detail. So what is this connective tissue? So here it is written, it is composed of widely scattered cells that lie within a large amount of non-living intercellular material. Living cells surrounded by a matrix. So if I talk about just like here. So if this is the, for example, this is something, this is a material that is made up of connective tissue. So according to the definition, we can see here that there is a matrix present in the middle. So middle part is called the matrix. So if I talk about this part, so here the middle part is called the matrix. So matrix is made up of the non-living cells, and they are the cells, the living cells are embedded in the non-living, that means in the outer side, and the inner side they are made up of the non-living cells. So if I talk about the function of the connective tissue, there are a lot of points given. So this is starting from the number one: enclosing and separating the organs. Just like if I am having my stomach, so if this is the stomach, just here only the pancreas will lie over here. So the separation in just between these things is done by the connective tissue. So connective tissue will be present in the that means in just between all these things, just like here it is present, here it is present, and again from here the small intestine will started. So this part, so every the blank part is just covered with the connective tissue. The next point: connecting tissue to one another, ligament and tendons. As we know that that means we are having a supportive system that is called the skeletal system. So in the skeletal system we are going to read about the two thing that is called the skeletal system, but we are having two connective tissue, that is called the ligament and the tendon. Just like for example, if we are having this hand, so in the hand the our outside we are having the skin, and in the middle we are having the muscles, and in the middle we are having the bone. So this middle part, the middle part, that means the this one is called the ligament. And I will clear this one, the ligament and the tendon. So that means the this one is called the tendon, that means the connection of bone to muscle. When the bone in this one, that means this part, when the bone is connecting with the muscle, this is called the tendon. And when bone is connecting with the bone, just like over here, so there is a joint. So when this bone is just jointing this bone over here, we will find out the ligament. The next point, supporting and moving. They are supporting and moving. They just that means they also joined bone to bone, and they also form the cartilage. The next function is storing adipose tissue and bones. Now here they are also showing that they store something. What they store? They store the fats. Now in the adipose tissue, we will talk about the fats. As we all know that everybody is having the fats in their body, so we call sometimes that I am having fat in my stomach or in my body. So we are talking about the fats. So about this, the adipose tissue, we are going to read in detail in the next part. Cushing and insulating adipose tissue. It is also, that means acting as a insulator. That means it is not allowing the heat to transfer. Transport and protection. That means we are going to read about the blood. So the blood is the very good transportation system, and it is the fastest transportation. The last one is the protection. So cranium and sternum we are having, that means the we will talk about the skeletal system. Over there we will see the protection, cranium and the sternum. That means mainly here it is talking about the bones. So these all are the function of the connective tissue. So in detail we are going to read in the next part. So first thing, the classification of connective tissue, that means how the connective tissue is categorized, how we are going to read, in how many classification. So broadly the connective tissue is classified into three major groups. The first one is the proper connective tissue. Here it is written, connective tissue proper. Okay, no problem. The next one we are having the fluid connective tissue, and the last one we are having the supporting connective tissue. So you can see just in the lower part only the function is also given. The three different connective tissue is having three different function. The first one is connect and protect. That means whatsoever coming in the proper connective tissue or in the connective tissue proper, they will help in the connection. That means they will connect the two thing and they will protect. The next one we are having the fluid connective tissue. They will always help in the transportation of the material from one place to the other. And in the third one, supporting connective tissue, that means they will help us in the structural strength. They will provide the strength. So let's read in detail. First